The evening was no different from any other. Rose did her shopping at the supermarket after work and hurried home. The woman entered the apartment and realized that her son was still not here. Rose sighed. Her 16-year-old son was walking somewhere instead of doing his homework again. Having been widowed early, the woman brought up her son alone. She was away at work all day and could not control Floyd. Quickly making dinner, the woman began to wait for her son. She made herself comfortable on the sofa with her favorite book, and did not notice how she dozed off to the monotonous sound of rain. She was awakened by voices. Rose glanced at her watch. It was almost 11 at night. She quickly rose from the couch and walked into the hallway, preparing to scold her son for returning so unacceptably late. Her son was standing on the doorstep, and beside him stood an unfamiliar girl about his age. The children were soaked to the skin and looked at the woman guiltily. Floyd timidly said that the girl's name was Emma and asked permission to spend the night at their house. Having recovered from her initial shock, Rose invited the children into the kitchen. She put the kettle on, and hastily looked for clothes for her drenched guest. While the children were eating and drinking tea, Rose asked if the girl's parents would be looking for her. The girl suddenly froze and stopped eating. And then she looked up at the woman with her sad and not childlike adult eyes, and said that they did not care. Rose decided to postpone serious conversations for the morning. She made a bed for the girl on the couch and told everyone to go to bed. In the morning, Floyd told his mother how he had met Emma in the street. The girl was standing on the corner outside their house, shriveled up like a wet bird. Floyd wanted to walk past her, but some force stopped him. He asked what was wrong with her and if she needed help. After listening to the girl's story, Floyd took her firmly by the hand and took her home. Emma's story was no different from the hundreds of other sad stories of children in families where parents drink. Drowning in alcohol, adults sometimes forget about their children, pushing them onto the streets. Some learn to survive there. Many simply disappear. Emma's parents drank regularly. To avoid seeing or hearing her drunken parents, the girl would often stay with friends after school or simply wandered the dark streets of the city. A few times she even climbed into the basement of a building like a stray kitten and fell asleep there. After Floyd told his mother everything, he said that they should definitely help her. At least let her stay with them for a while. The boy's big brown eyes shone with such hope and eagerness to help, that Rose could not refuse, and said she would think about it. When Emma woke up, Rose fed the children breakfast. She looked at the skinny teenage girl with so scratchy look, and her heart ached. The woman decided to look at her parents first with her own eyes. She could not believe that they were not worried and not looking for their lost daughter. She asked Emma for her address and went to find out. As it turned out, the girl lived on the outskirts of the city, and Rose did not understand how she ended up so far from home. In the apartment where Rose came, no one responded to the doorbell. Then the woman began persistently knocking on the door. Finally, there was some movement, and soon the door was opened by an unshaven man with a swollen face. He unfriendly looked at the uninvited woman, and was very surprised when Rose began to talk about their daughter. Emma's father thought it was someone from school and let the woman into the apartment. Emma's mother was apparently lying on the old couch, and she was clearly unhappy about being woken up. At the question about her daughter, she said indifferently that she did not know where she was, but she was not going anywhere, she would take a walk and come back. Her words were interspersed with coarse scolding, and then she turned her back to the wall, making it clear that the conversation was over. Having failed to talk properly with Emma's parents, Rose rang the doorbell next door. Their neighbor eagerly began to tell her everything she knew about that family. According to her, there were constantly drunken gatherings. Emma hung out with her neighbors at first, and when she grew up a little, she began to disappear into the unknown. Rose was walking through the Autumn City and a decision came to her mind. The girl would live with her, if of course she wanted to. Where there is one child, there will be another. Especially since she had always wanted a daughter. When Rose returned home, she asked Emma about it, and the girl agreed. A few days later, the woman went to see her parents again, and told them that she could take care of all the trouble and expenses related to their daughter. They were only happy and didn't object. Emma has since settled into a new family. The never-depressed girl did not let anyone be sad. She helped Rose at home, and looking at her, Floyd also learned to work. It was like a ray of sunshine settled in this family. To Rose's surprise, they were both doing much better in school, because they often did homework together. Rose looked at the children's cheerful faces and was glad. Although Emma lived for some time as a child on the streets, it did not spoil her. The girl's soul gradually warmed up in this hospitable family. One day, accidentally repeating after Floyd, Emma called Rose "Mom," but the woman did not correct her. As time passed, Emma and Floyd finished school, got a profession and became adults. All that time they hardly ever parted and did everything together. Emma and Floyd tried to date others, but they soon realized what true feelings there were between them. Their friendship was gradually and imperceptibly replaced by love. The lovers did not put off the wedding for a long time and soon got married. They knew each other very well and wanted to be together forever. A year later, they had a wonderful baby girl. Rose was sincerely happy and often recalled the day she did not remain indifferent to Emma's troubles. But happiness did not last long. Soon Floyd was suddenly diagnosed with a serious blood disease. Endless hospitals, medical procedures, the search for the right medicine and competent doctors began. Floyd grew weaker every day. Rose did not know how she would have survived all this, if it were not for the constant support from Emma. The young woman managed everything. She visited her husband in the hospital, helped with household chores and shopping, took care of Floyd during those brief periods when he was discharged home. And most importantly, she did not let her family get discouraged, invariably charging everyone with hope for the best. However, no miracle happened. The disease progressed, and 6 months later Floyd died. Rose found it infinitely painful to accept that her only son had passed away. Once again, the woman could not cope without the support and care of her daughter-in-law. For a few more years, Emma lived with Floyd's mother. And then another man came into the young woman's life. Emma honestly told everything to Rose. But the woman did not condemn her daughter-in-law, because the loving heart of a mother understands everything. Rose blessed Emma to arrange her own personal life. After all, Floyd would want happiness for his beloved. With bowed heads, the two women looked at Floyd's picture. His clear eyes warmed their hearts as if looking into their souls. Emma hugged Rose and thanked her for everything. In this house she found a real mother, found and lost her first love. This is where her memory and heart will always return. Dear friends, I hope you enjoyed this story. It teaches us not to be deaf to other people's troubles, especially if it concerns a defenseless child. I wish you a good mood, and I wish all the children on this planet to have loving parents.